My prayer is that as the word of God comes into you through the right eye, yeah, it will not go out through the left ear in the mighty name of Jesus. Do you know why? Many people you see sleeping, they've been believers for several years. If they are to be counting how many messages they have sat under, they can't even remember. But the question is, where is the Lord? What is it? What happens to the word of God in the life of a Christian? How I wish we are doing Bible study. What happens to the word of God? Why? Because that word is your key. That word is what you need. Without that word, your marriage cannot be better. That's why I have issues with our women. When you hear the word of God, put it to practice in your marriage. The men too, when you hear the word of God, put it to practice in your business. Put it to practice in your life. Don't hear the word of God and come and do according to the flesh. You will wreck your life. The word of God. The Bible says in the beginning there was the word, and the word was God. And God spoke. Everything was on the word. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This morning we are going to look at the topic which says the parable of the sower. What did I say? The parable of the sower. Join me as I go into the book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 13. Matthew chapter 13, I'm going to read from verse 14. Matthew 13, I'm going to read from 14 to 23. Are you there with me? Praise the Lord. Verse 16 now. Verse 16. He said, "But blessed are your eyes, for they see." If you need to underline your Bible, please do it this morning. The Bible says, "Blessed are your what? Your eyes, for they see. And your ear, for they hear." You know why he said that? There are some people cannot see, some people they cannot hear. The judgment God will give to those who will be different from your own. You can see and you can hear. Everything you have seen and everything you are hearing, you give account for it. Don't play with the word of God. 17. For assuredly I say to you that many prophets and righteous men desire to see what you see and did not see, and to hear what you hear and did not hear it. Let's go to the main verse now, 18. Therefore, hear the parable of the sower. When someone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand it, please follow me closely now. You got to distinguish the things. 19. When anyone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand it, then the wicked one comes and snatches away what was sown in his heart. This is he who receives seed by the wayside. That means that sower sowed that seed at the wayside. 20. But he who receives the seed on a stony place, this is he who hears the word, immediately receive it with joy. Please follow. I want to distinguish it so that you will know which category do you belong. Immediately receive it with joy. 21. But he has no root in himself, but endures only for a while. That word he has. Endures only for a while. For when tribulation or persecution arises because of the word, immediately he stumbled. Did you see that? The Bible puts immediately. Immediately he stumbled. Go to 22. Now, he who receives seed among thorns is he who hears the word Three. What's the first one? What is the problem of the first one? You couldn't understand, right? What's the problem of the second one? Tribulation. Eh? Stony heart. Come again? What is the problem of the third one? Eh? Okay, when the fullness and riches touch the world, becomes unfruitful. 23. But he who receives seed on the good ground. Look at me, church. Look at me, church. The Bible says there is a ground called the good ground. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says there is a ground called stony ground. There is a ground called ground of thorns. What's the first ground again? The last ground, he said there is a ground called good ground. Do you know where I'm going for this morning? What the Bible is saying is that every time you come to church like this, the majority of the worshipers that come to church, they have four kinds of hearts. There are some, they have stony hearts. Some have the one with thorns. Some has good ground. And what are we driving out this morning? The parable of the sower. And what I want us to look into this morning is that you and I, we are the determiner of our worst thing and our best thing. It is by yourself that you will determine either you will enjoy your life or not. Follow me closely. The Bible says there is a sower. The job of that sower is to go ahead and look for a place where he will sow and the seed will germinate. And the Bible says as the sower goes, he got to one ground, that ground has thorn. He got to another ground, that ground is thorny. He got to another ground, different kind of ground, but he got to a ground. Good ground. You know, I didn't read it that much. That is an example. That is an homework for you. So to read the Bible, you will see. But this morning, church, hear me. The gospel is facing a challenge. You know the challenge the gospel is facing? The gospel is facing a challenge of people that are not having good ground for the word of God. And if you look at the number three, he said, once they receive the word, the riches and the deceitfulness of this world choke the world and they forget what they have done. Hear me, John. Many people are going through challenges. You forgot that you have received something at one time or the other. The word. If you allow that word to choke inside you, you're going to suffer. The question is, why is that sower? Why is this sowing? Those things. What is the importance of those things? You don't understand. He went to a place, stored there, he saw. He went to this one, he saw. What is his problem? Why is he so in? For what? Brethren, the sower knows that that word is sowing will be of immense importance to whichever ground that allows you to go. That's why when you read, when you go back to that one, he said the word will be the good ground. When he said it multiplied. Hear me, John. Devil has one business in the gospel of today to ensure that the word of God did not germinate in your life. It is not about going to church. I have said it here before, I am still saying it. Every church around here, there are powers assigned to do what? To go around those churches to ensure that the word of God is not planted in people's hearts. And that's why they go and they come back the same thing every day. But this morning, hear the parable of the sower. You can't collect the word of God. Land in the good side in your life. What are the characteristics? The first one, the Bible tells us why those words were not germinating. Why? The second one is because of deceitfulness. Once they deceive him, you know, you cannot hold on to the fact. When problems come, once challenges come, they will tell you, is it because of your child? Is it because of your work? You need to go here. He said, deceitfulness killed the world in that person. The other one is stoning. He said he could, he said the first one could not understand. Brethren, the only category of the people that will not understand the word of God is the people that are not giving their life to Christ. When you give your life to Christ and you start coming to the Lord gives understanding. Of course, when you give your life to Christ, you have to endeavor. Endeavor to do what? To study the word. Bible is not notebook. Bible is not a newspaper. Bible is not storybook. You don't expect to understand the Bible like you understand all those literature. No. Bible understanding comes from the Holy Spirit.